Hi folks, this is David Kwan. This is kind of the second part in me talking about my kind of personal encounters with homelessness when I was during my winter break. When I was in Iowa, I encountered a homeless man, and you know, he's not the very stereotypical image of homeless man, but I just know, you know, it's an image that is so easy to. You don't really need to explain, like, oh, I saw a homeless man. For some reason, it's a powerful image that's been ingrained in us. We don't, when I say, like, I met a homeless guy, people don't normally immediately think of a 11th grade student in attending high school. You know, that's not the image that first comes to their mind. Although that would be a more accurate image of a homeless person. It would be more, because there are more of those kind of homeless people compared to the actual stereotypical image of homelessness. But it's just who we encounter on the street. We don't, unless we're searching for homeless people, seeking for homeless people, we're not going to go into public high schools or shelters or hotels or churches or people's family's home. You know, we don't do that. We walk about our lives, we go about our lives, and people out there we see are homeless. These are the noticeable homeless, the unsheltered homeless. So, definitions of homelessness, for example, doubled up families is not considered homeless in pretty much majority of United States. I would personally say they should be, but that's a different discussion altogether. In Washington, D.C., the minute I set foot in Washington, D.C., almost like, you know, homelessness kind of found me. Or it's just there. I encountered it. And this time I interacted with it. And this is a very horrible language on my part. I'm saying I'm interacted with it. That's almost like objectifying homelessness. But it's a horrible way. So that is a mistake on my part. I meant to say, you know, I interacted with the person, with the woman, who's clearly experiencing homelessness. But I get off at, I think Union Station. It's a bus station, train station. But I took a bus to Washington D.C. I get off. I try to transfer to the Washington D.C. subway system, and I feel so lost at that point. You know, I'm so used to New York City subway trains. So this is a very weird feeling, like, oh, I'm using the subway, but I have kind of no idea how to use this thing. It's such a weird feeling because in New York City, I'm using subway all the time. I don't even need a map. I could just use it. But Washington D.C., I'm there. It's like, whoa, the ticketing system is different. I don't know how to get the ticket. How to use the ticket? I was so totally lost. And apparently, this is very seemingly apparent because there's this homeless woman who, I guess, noticed that. She came up to me. And she's like, oh, she started talking to me. I think most people in this situation, unfortunately, most people ignore it. And they just say, most people don't even say anything, I think. They just kind of walk away. And they don't say hi. They don't look to the person. They walk away. But this person was speaking to me. And I was kind of messed up, like, figuring out how to work the subway system. So, you know, I responded, "Hey, how's it going?" Bad way to start, by the way, but you know, it's a normal greeting. And, "Hey, how's it going?" It's like, "Oh, not so well. You know, I've been here, you know, just a few weeks now, and I'm not really sure what's going on here too. But as you can see, I'm homeless." And she's to put it in context, she's a don't really like giving the context a lot because it also brings up preconceived notions about a person. Like, we, you know, when we start, I think identity is one thing when you start to learn more about that person, and identity just happens to be, like, for example, my age and identity is just something that I happen to be. But, like, when you briefly describe a person and you briefly, like, you just mention their identity label, our mind has a way of categorizing things that, like, that defines them. You know, if somebody was just talking about, oh, I met this guy, he was Asian, you know, that he was Asian statement kind of defines who that person is, even though it's so, you know, I'm not going to put it in context on second thought, because I was going to tell you. But anyway, to not get this person into a preconceived context, because I only talked with her for 10 minutes. That's the, you know, judging a person based on 10 minutes of interaction is a very fraught thing to do. So I started this conversation. She's telling me, like, you know, I need money, I need to get out of here and whatnot. I was actually in a very, very tough financial situation. That's probably next future, very near future video we'll be talking about, kind of the financial situation I was in right after the break till this point. And still kind of am, but I, you know, but it's nothing compared to her situation, of course. You know, but that's homelessness. So I mean, who can compare? No one should be able to compare. That's homelessness, in my personal opinion, shouldn't even exist. When homelessness exists in a society, I think society has a problem, and society needs to kind of work together to fix that. And that's why I'm in this field. I want to work in a field, you know, that's in a field that shouldn't exist. I shouldn't have a job. After I graduate, you know, there shouldn't be a job opening for me, but there is. That's a problem, I think. Anyway, or at least it should be a different kind of job, like preventing homelessness or, you know, helping people maintain their affordable housing. But getting people out of homelessness is an issue. I think my personal that aside. You know, 10 minutes talking, and she's just telling me, and I'm just there. I can't give her money. Is the first thing that kind of, you know, comes is ingrained in my head. It's like I should not give her money. I have barely enough to survive a week in D.C. And in D.C. it's gonna be a very challenging thing. You know, and I actually have a lot in cash, but it's that cash is just for that week, and it's gonna be spent that week like that. So it's just like, oh. You know, I don't know what to do. So, you know, the very best thing, usually thing I wasn't able to do this. I don't know why, but I was caught up. I should have been, the thing to do is be very clear from the beginning. You know, it's like, hey, I understand what you're going through. Don't say that. Don't say I understand what you're going through. That's a horrible thing to say. I don't know why I'm like stuttering now, because I'm thinking back to that moment, and it's just like, oh, God. Why did I do what I did? You know, this is a reflection moment for me. But it's like, okay, well, you know, that's sounds like a rough thing that you're going through. And, you know, all I can do right now, I got to be clear from the beginning, you know, that I cannot give you money. That is not in a manner in which I can help you today, right now. But it you know, I could have stated my business. You know, I'm here in Washington D.C. for the first time. I'm trying to get this ticket to go to this school building. But on my way, if there's any other way that I can help you, I'll be glad to be here. I'm glad, you know, I don't have to go there by a certain time, unless it's 3 hours from now. But you know, I have 3 hours, so I can talk to you. If you need to talk to me, that's fine. If you need to help using my cell phone, any other way that I can help you, I'm willing to do, but I can't give you money today. I should have been very clear like that from the very beginning, except I wasn't. I wasn't able to make that statement, but anyway, we got to talking, and then I was like, I have to do this ticket machine, and obviously, she has no idea how to use it either, but she's in such a dire circumstances, she needs to, she's got me hooked, so I'm talking to her. So for her, I think that's a lot of what I notice with people experiencing homelessness. When a person responds to you, that's amazing, because almost no one does when you're on the streets. So when you have a person actually talking to you, that's something amazing. So she's talking to me, I'm talking to her, that's something. So she's got me, you know. And so I just want to say bye. I just want to try to figure out how to work this thing, but she's still near me, and she's trying to actually help me. Like, you know, I've been in Washington D.C. She has no idea what she's doing. I can see that, because, you know, but, you know, I can't really, like, just be like, you know, I don't think you know how to do it either. That would be very rude. So I just kind of take a sit back, and I let her help me. I allow her to figure things out, but I've already figured it out at that point to help me figure it out. which was an arrogant, condescending part on my part. You know, it's a very arrogant thing to do. It's better to be clear up front. But this is why I'm going back to that moment where I'm just realizing that interaction, man. I could have been a lot better. I've done a horrible job with that interaction. But so I get my ticket, and by that point, you know, she's just like, now will you give me money? It's that conversation has totally changed now. She helped me get my ticket. She did a service to me now. So it's like I have to pay her now, or that's the feeling. People watching this will probably argue like, no, you don't have to pay her. It's not your you're not obligated to do that. It was not a contract service, whatever. But the emotional feeling at that moment is she helped me do something. She's in a dire situation. I didn't make it clear to her from the beginning that I was going to give her money, that was not my intention, and that I didn't tell her during it that I figured it out. I didn't need her help, because I saying that to her directly as we're doing it would have been very rude, I thought. So by that point, she asks very assertively. I commend her for her assertiveness. I think that's people will probably think that like, oh, how dare she do that? But what I thought was like, wow, that's very bold of her, and that's actually like a very good, strong, positive trait of her that she can kind of take charge like that. So she's just like, now will you give me money? And that's, you know, I couldn't say no. So I was just like, okay, well, so I try to take out my wallet and try to take out like tiny bit of cash because I don't want her to see that I have a lot. Although that's a stupid thinking on my part. Like, so what? You know, what if she sees it, and she demands it, and then that could be a conversation. Like, well, I see you have a 20 there. Why can't you give me a 20? That could be a conversation in which, you know, like, well, you know, I that would be more of a hampering conversation, but it's still a conversation that could be had. That's a weird thing about interacting with homeless person. Sometimes it becomes like a bartering situation where. It feels very wrong to do, you know. It's a very different type of feeling if I really originally intended to buy something from someone compared to like this situation where I feel compelled to pay something for a service that I didn't even really want, you know. But nonetheless, I was given the service, so you know it became like a fee for service money transaction, which is just. Not the right kind of interaction with, you know, I would want to have with a person experiencing homelessness. So that was my second encounter in D.C. And it just was an interesting way to start the week at D.C. Like I came, I was in Iowa for 2 weeks and didn't really encounter homelessness all that much except for that one instance. And then I came to D.C. and right as I get off the bus and transferring to the subway station, boom, there I am interacting with the homeless person. And actually in D.C. I encountered, interacted and witnessed people experiencing homelessness a good amount of times. And I'll say I can still count with my two hands, but not with my one. So less than 10, but more than 5, right? So that was Washington, D.C. And it was interesting. Like I'm in a completely different city. Very different from New York City in a lot of ways. Feels pretty similar in some ways, but you know it's that was it, you know, and that was interesting. In the next video, I guess I'll talk about you know where this is going, how I encounter homelessness right as I come back to New York City.